Hello everyone. So nice to meet you all after almost a week since the completion of the 5 days online FTP on evolution of teaching learning process post COVID-19. So hope all of you are doing very well, staying safe and doing good. Regarding your use certificates, so in this video I will explain to you the downloading procedure and also the possible queries that may arise when you are downloading your certificate. So please follow the instructions given in this video and download your e-certificates. See you all soon in another program and catch up with the video. Thank you. So on behalf of Bharat University, first of all let me thank you all for having participated in the 5 days online faculty development program on evolution of teaching learning process post COVID-19. So in this video we are going to see how to download your e-certificates. So we'll be discussing about the eligibility conditions and also in detail explaining you about the downloading procedure and also the authentication procedure, and I'll be answering a few queries which normally arise when you are downloading this. So the eligibility conditions for downloading your e-certificate would be: you should have submitted your feedback form, which was displayed on the chat window on the last session of the program, and also you should have submitted the quiz, which was also again the link for which was given during the last session of the program, and you should have attended at least 8 sessions. As I have been insisting, minimum 80% of attendance was the requirement, and you should have submitted at least the attendance form for 8 sessions. And the e-certificate download will begin from 22nd of this month, that is from tomorrow Friday evening 3 p.m. you will be able to download your e-certificates. So for downloading your e-certificate, you have to visit bharatuni.ac.in, our website, and there you can see the scroll that's running which says the 5-day online FDP e-certificate download. So once you click that download, you can see this screen which will be asking you to enter your email address and your date of birth. So while doing this, please remember that your date of birth should be entered in the first it comes the month, then the date, then the year. It should be MMDDYYYY format, and also your email ID, that should be the same ID which you submitted during your feedback form. So please remember that both your email ID and the date of birth, these are the data that you filled in your feedback form. So once you have done that, as shown in the screen, click the submit button. So once you submit, then this screen will appear. So it will show your name, your email ID, and then there you can see that click to download certificate, download certificate. So once you click on that download certificate, your certificate will begin to download, and this is a sample certificate which we have displayed. So this certificate shows your name and also your institution name, which we have been already, as we have already told, have been taken from the feedback form that you submitted. And on the left, top left, you can see the e-certificate number. The reason for giving this e-certificate number I'll explain to you later. So on your screen now you have your e-certificate for having participated in the 5 days online faculty development program on evolution of teaching learning process post COVID-19, conducted from 11th May to 15th May 2020 by Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research, a deemed to be university in Chennai. So e-certificate authentication, as I told you, the reason for having given that e-certificate number is to avoid any photocopies, any duplication, photoshopping of the e-certificate. Hence we have introduced this e-certificate authentication procedure, and this procedure will be obviously only for downloaded certificates. So in order to authenticate your certificate, you should have downloaded your certificate. So once you have downloaded your certificate, in case you want to authenticate it, or once you submit it to your employer and your employer wants to verify the authenticity of the certificate, then they have to visit the Bharat University website, that is bharatunif.ac.in, and then click the scroll 5-day online FDP e-certificate authentication. Please remember, there will be two scrolls that would be running. One would be for the e-certificate downloading and the other one would be for the e-certificate authentication. So once you click on the e-certificate authentication scroll, this is what will come up on your screen. So for checking the authenticity of your certificate, you need two data. One is the e-certificate number, which as I told you would appear on the top left corner of your e-certificate. That would be 8 characters in that. And then you also need to enter your date of birth, again in the same MMDDYYYY format. So again here the e-certificate number, for example in the sample certificate shown, it is FDPR5678. So you need to enter all these 8 characters. You need to enter FDPR5678. So enter that 8-digit alphanumeric e-certificate number. As said, it is on the top left corner of your certificate, FDPR. So in your certificate, whatever number is given, XXXX. So you need to enter all the 8 characters and also enter your date of birth in the MMDDYY format. And once you do that and you hit the submit button, provided the data is correct, then your e-certificate will be authenticated. And please remember that this authentication facility will be available only up to 30th of June 2020, after which the authentication can be verified through the email, and that email ID is also printed on your e-certificate at the bottom line. And before that, until 30th of June, this authentication will be done only on the website, and we won't be answering any emails for authentication until 30th of June. So after that, if you or your employer wants to authenticate the certificate, then you can very well email us, send us an email quoting your e-certificate number to the email ID that is mentioned on your e-certificate. And please remember that it would take us 5 to 7 working days to respond to your email regarding the authentication of your e-certificate. So once your e-certificate is authentic, the top screen comes, your e-certificate is authentic, or else in case any data is not matching, then it will say, sorry, invalid details, please verify your e-certificate number and date of birth. So this provision, authentication provision, we have included to ensure that only those people who have really attended for minimum 8 sessions and taken the quiz program, only those who have really benefited from the program are certified. And that is the reason why we are giving this authentication procedure for you, and to avoid duplication of the e-certificates. So once your e-certificate is authentic, the first half of the screen is what will appear on the authentication procedure, and in case something is wrong, it will say invalid details, please verify your e-certificate number and date of birth. So what happens if your e-certificate is not downloaded? The reasons can be that the data may not be matching. For example, the email ID which you have given now may not match with the email ID which you had submitted during your feedback form, or the date of birth may not be matching. So please check the credentials once again, the spelling, in case any unwanted space is there, the numbers, whether you have entered correctly. More importantly, I am specifying on numbers because please remember that the date of birth should be in first month and then the date format. It is MMDDYYYY format. It is American style. So that is the reason why I am specifying on numbers. So in case if both are right, then the reason may be that you might not have submitted the feedback form at all. In case you have not submitted the feedback form, then your e-certificate will not be generated, because as I have been repeatedly telling you, even during the sessions, the e-certificate, it's an automatic software. So the data has been extracted from the feedback forms that have been submitted, and we had received 953 feedback forms to be precise, and only that number of certificates have been generated. So in case you have not submitted your feedback form, then your certificate would not have been generated, and that is the reason why it says credentials are not matching. And then another reason may be that you have not attended 8 sessions. So if you have not submitted the attendance form for minimum 8 sessions, that may also be a reason for your e-certificate for not being downloaded. So regarding the feedback, as the asterisk mark says at the bottom of your screen, you see now it says the feedback form link was given during the final session of the FDP. Because we have been getting emails saying that, sir, feedback I did not receive, please email me the feedback, please email me the feedback. That was not possible, and even now it is not possible, because as said earlier, the feedback form link, and also please look at the last line, the attendance form for session 7 to 10, it was displayed on the chat box while the online webinar was going on towards the end of the session, and the attendance form for sessions 7 through 10 was given during the respective sessions only, and this was already communicated to you via the email communication sent to you on 13th, that is the third day of the program, and only from the fourth day we started sharing it, because we found that the numbers which the faculties were submitting the attendance certificate and the numbers that were on the webinar and the Facebook page or on the YouTube page were not tallying. So in order to avoid that discrepancy, the attendance form for session 7 through 10 was included in the chat box. So in case your e-certificate is not being downloaded, it may be due to either of these two reasons. One being that the feedback form was not submitted, and the other may be that you have not submitted the attendance form for minimum 8 sessions. So now what to do in case of this? So it will say invalid details, please verify your email ID and date of birth. Just hit OK. And what to do, sir, after this? I'll tell you in the following screen. In case you feel that no, sir, I have submitted our feedback form, I have submitted that already, but still the e-certificate is not downloaded, then please send us an email with the following title in the subject. Just say that it is feedback submitted already. Okay, so please send us an email. On the subject line, type feedback submitted already. All right, so this will give us a, because we are segregating the emails based on the subject line. Again, it is automated. If you include any other character on the subject line, it may bounce back to you or it may not reach us, and it will not be segregated by the software. So on the subject line, just type feedback submitted already and nothing else. And if you have not submitted the feedback form, but you have submitted the attendance form for the 8 sessions, then again send us an email. Only thing is, on the subject line, please type the words feedback not submitted. Only these 3 words we want. Feedback not submitted. So once you do that, then it will automatically come to that mailbox which is taking care of that. So only 2 cases, let me repeat. One is feedback submitted already, and another one is attendance has been submitted, but due to some reason you could not submit the feedback. So in that second case, then your subject line would read as feedback not submitted. So send these emails only to these, either one of these 4 email IDs, either FDP batch 1 or FDP batch 2 or FDP batch 3 or FDP batch 4. Only one of these email IDs, which one to send, you know it very well, because you have been receiving the communications from that email ID only. All the communications that you have received from our office regarding this FTP program has been through only one email ID. Since we had more than 2000 participants, we had segregated you into 4 different batches: batch 1, batch 2, batch 3, batch 4, and you have been communicated only from the corresponding email IDs. So please check from where you have been receiving the emails, from which email ID, whether you belong to batch 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. Please don't send us an email asking, sir, which batch do I belong? Because all the communications you have been receiving only from that corresponding email IDs. So please send your queries to FDP batch 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. And one important thing, please note that if all the communications you have been receiving from, say for example, FDP batch 2, and now when sending the query email, you are sending it to any other, say batch 3 or 4, then the system will not recognize your credentials and you will not get any reply. And you will be getting frustrated saying that I sent an email but I did not get a reply. So the reason will be that your communication would have been from a different mail ID, whereas now you may be sending it to a different mail ID. So while you are sending your queries, please remember that you can send only to one of these four, not to all the four. Same way, please don't mark CC to other three. Please don't do that because the system won't recognize that. You won't get any replies for that. So only one to address, it would either be batch 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. That too only for two cases. As I told you earlier, first case was feedback submitted, sir, but e-certificate not downloaded. And the second case, sir, attendance I have given for 8 sessions, but feedbacks due to some reason I could not submit. So only these two cases, please send us an email. As said earlier, let me repeat. These are the two cases. The first case, feedback form already submitted, but due to some reason e-certificate not able to download means, please send us an email. On the subject line, just type these three words, feedback submitted already. This is case one. And case two is, if you have not submitted the feedback, but you have attended for 8 sessions and also submitted the attendance, then on the subject line, please type the three words, feedback not submitted, and send this to only one of these IDs. Please note, my dear participants, only one of these four IDs. If it's a mismatch, be rest assured you will not get any reply. And for this e-certificate query, please note that if you have not submitted the feedback and also not submitted the attendance form for the 8 sessions, then please don't send any emails because your emails will not be responded to. So you should have submitted the feedback, or you should have at least attended 8 sessions and submitted the attendance form. In case if it's a no for both the terms, sir, I did not submit the feedback, sir, I have not attended 8 sessions means, then by default you are not eligible for getting the e-certificate. So please don't send any query emails because your emails will not be replied. So I hope that I have given a satisfactory explanation regarding the downloading of the certificates. So thank you all once again, and I hope to see you all soon. Thank you very much. Thank you.